We've brought you here for a little chat about your teeth and some good news. An instrument made to get between teeth that you can comfortably use at home. The new generation Crest Complete. First, Crest created a brush to fit your teeth, designed to penetrate and clean far between them. Now, new Crest Complete goes even farther than before. The better you care for your teeth, the more you and your dentist can enjoy these little visits. New Crest Complete, the dentist's choice for rippled brushes.
Alternative math. One croissant sandwich plus one hash brown plus one coffee equals $1.99 every day. Add it to your morning at Burger King.
We may not be the world's number one fast food place. It just tastes that way.
If you missed today's NFL Live, you missed all you need to know about the late-breaking Sterling Sharp story.
I don't think you walk out on your teammates and players.
And that Sanders guy got Mike's attention.
Neon or Dion or whatever his name is. If he wants to play, he'll play. I don't think he wants to play.
Next Sunday, 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 a.m. Pacific.
This is the Domino's Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report, brought to you by Domino's Pizza. When it's gotta be good, and it's gotta be now, it's gotta be Domino's.
And welcome, everyone, to our studio here in New York. Greg Gumbel, Mike Ditka, Joe Gibbs. Those of you watching the Jets-Buffalo game will be immensely interested in what's happening at Joe Robbie Stadium between the Dolphins and the New England Patriots. And we'll show you. This game is a 14-7 New England lead in the second quarter. Quarterback Dan Marino entering Joe Robbie Stadium, trying to come back from the ruptured Achilles tendon. His pass off the hands of Keith Byers. Dwayne Saab picks it off. Stepped out of bounds at the 9-yard line, and with his mistake, Dan Marino's not at all pleased, but he made up for it a little bit later. Watch this strike. In the mud, out of the mud. The Mark Ingram in full stride, 64 yards and a touchdown. Marino's 299th career touchdown to tie the game at 7. But just before halftime, Drew Bledsoe to Ben Coates. Great catch in the corner of the end zone with 25 seconds remaining to give New England a 14-7 lead at halftime. At Three Rivers Stadium in Pittsburgh, the Cowboys and the Steelers are in the second quarter, and Dallas leads this one by a score of 13-3. A couple of Chris Bonnio field goals, and Gary Anderson has a field goal for Pittsburgh. Darrell Johnson, 21-yard touchdown for the Dallas Cowboys, who lead it 13-3. The game that you're watching, the Jets and the Bills, New York leads it 17-3 at halftime. You know, I've thought the world of Pete Carroll as a defensive coordinator. He apparently has the ability to inspire this Jets team.
Well, I'll tell you, the players are playing awfully well in this football game. Pete's done a great job, but the players are doing the job. They're doing the things they have to do on offense and defense. But the main thing, their defense is playing very well.
And there's a history of losing to the Bills, too, Joe.
And a tough place playing up there. I tell you what, I'm surprised by this. Yeah. So we got to see what happens in the second half.
17-3 is the score. Boomer Esiason, 9 of 16, 148 yards so far in the game. And in Anaheim, the Rams hosting the Arizona Cardinals and leading the Cardinals in the second quarter. 7-3 is the score there. Todd Light, a 74-yard fumble recovery for the only touchdown of the game. Greg Davis, a 37-yard field goal for Arizona. We've got plenty of highlights from the early games. We'll get to those right after these words from your local station.
Run, you bum, run!
Dad, how can you watch this barbaric display?
Actually, Niles, football serves a very important purpose in our society. Provides an outlet for aggression arising from feelings of frustration, quite often sexual in origin.
Oh, please spare us your half-baked Freudian analyses.
Oh, does number 62 look nice in those tight pants?
Kill him! Kill him!
Frasier's moving to Tuesday nights in 2 weeks.
Kill him! Kill him!
Niles, he's on our team!
It's like a great high, right?
First time.
How'd you know?
Just a hunch.
How'd she get away from you?
The facts don't add up.
I hooked her in!
And nothing is what it seems.
But she'll kiss her.
I just want you to see that she's come back from the dead.
Ditch Brody's life is on the line.
You have 5 seconds. One!
You gotta be kidding me.
Two! Four!
What happened to three?
And his only choice is to take the fall. Charlie Sheen, Nastasia Kinski, Terminal Velocity, rated PG-13. Starts Friday, September 23rd.
Sally Brown on the uneven bars.
No matter how well you plan, no matter how hard you try, there's always the possibility that something can go wrong. That's why nobody should be without the protection of a big, strong insurance company, MetLife. Get Met. It pays.
Still working with prehistoric copiers? Get the copier that earned Virus Lab's highest rating for uptime, Mita. For a more productive future, the times demand Mita.
Get ready for this year's first big college matchup. Number 3 Notre Dame, number 5 Michigan, in football's top rivalry. Last year, the Irish upset the Wolverines on their home turf. Now Michigan's out to return the favor when they face a Lou Holtz squad led by sensational quarterback Ron Paulus, fresh off his record-setting debut. Next Saturday at 2:30 Eastern, the showdown on NBC.
When it's gotta be good, and it's gotta be now, it's gotta be Domino's.
Welcome back, everyone. Let's run down the scores now for you from action earlier in the day, beginning with the Chiefs' visit to the New Orleans Saints in the Superdome, and Marty Schottenheimer got himself career victory number 100. Big game for both Joe Montana and Marcus Allen. Montana to Willie Davis for an 11-yard touchdown here in the first quarter. Montana 315 yards and two TDs on the day. And then in the second quarter, it was Allen on a 1-yard touchdown run. He carried 17 times for 82 yards. It was a 14-0 Chiefs lead. In the fourth quarter, defensive end Neil Smith with the deflection and interception of Jim Everett's pass, he returns 41 yards to set up the Saints' final touchdown. Kansas City won it by a 30-17 score. We told you Montana's numbers. Marcus Allen, 82 yards and a touchdown rushing. Jim Everett, 26 of 37, 326 yards. But obviously, guys, Everett had to throw, being behind from early on in the ball game. And you've got to hand it to those veterans for Kansas City. They did the job.
Well, they had an outstanding game, but I think a lot has to do with New Orleans. You know, they really lost a lot of their defense. They've gone a kind of an offensive philosophy. They'll throw the ball. They'll probably be a lot more successful in offense. But they don't have the defense anymore. They don't have that intimidating defense that you fear, and that's going to be a problem for them all year.
That was the best half that we saw, the first half by Kansas City. That's the best all-around half in football today that we saw, and I think it was tough for New Orleans to bounce back from that.
If they were looking for a way to establish themselves as a Super Bowl contender, the Chiefs found it today, 30-17, the final. At the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, the Giants over the Philadelphia Eagles today, 28-23. Rookie quarterback Dave Brown, pretty good afternoon, as did all-purpose back Dave Meggett. On special teams, he excelled, recovered a fumble, and returned this punt 68 yards for the score. Fifth time in his career, he has returned a punt for a touchdown. Giants led by a score of 14-0. In the third quarter, Meggett turned in this spectacular run. Behind perfect blocking, Giants beat the Eagles 28-23. The numbers on the afternoon for this game tell the story. Randall Cunningham, 344 yards and two touchdowns, but his Eagles came up short. Dave Brown, 10 of 20, 171 yards. Sounds typical of a New York Giant quarterback. And Dave Meggett, a couple of touchdowns as the Giants go 1-0 on the year. At Indianapolis, the Colts got the most out of their rookie running back, Marshall Faulk, as they beat the Oilers 45-21. The number two pick overall in the NFL draft. Here is his first career touchdown from 2 yards out. Indianapolis leads it 7-0. The Colts continued to capitalize on Oiler turnovers today. Faulk got his second of the half over the top from 2 yards out, 35-0 Indy. And then in the third, 11 yards to the end zone. His third of the day, and Marshall Faulk just chalks up the yardage, 143 in all, three touchdowns. Jim Harbaugh, 105 yards, and the Houston Oilers really showed some wear and tear and some signs that they are not going to be the force that they've been the last couple of years, Joe.
Well, we talked about the big trade. Hey, when Moon leaves, Cody's got to step in. Not only they don't get the job done today, but he also gets hurt.
All right, and the Green Bay Packers at Lambeau Field today, a winner over the Minnesota Vikings, 16-10, the final score in the battle between the two teams that are expected to vie for the title in the NFC Central. Warren Moon suffering from a sty in his eye that blurred his vision. His first pass as a Viking off the hands of Quadri Ismail, picked off by George Teague. Teague had two interceptions today. This led to a Chris Jackie field goal and a 3-0 Green Bay lead. Sterling Sharp rejoined his teammates after threatening to sit out today's opener and was on the receiving end of this 14-yard scoring strike from Brett Favre. Packers beat the Vikings for the first time since 1991. The final at Lambeau Field, 16-10 Green Bay. Moon, 12 completions in 37 attempts for 166 yards and intercepted 3 times, Mike.
Well, you know, maybe the change of pace is not going to help him up there, but I think Warren Moon's a good football player and he'll settle in. I think the thing that's impressive is Favre didn't throw any interceptions today. He had one turnover on a fumble, but I think the Packers did enough to win, and they did enough in a very hectic week with a sharp situation. I think it was a big victory for them.
All right, Mike, big victory for the Seattle Seahawks. They opened at RFK Stadium today and beat the Redskins by a score of 28-7. Chris Warren, 101 yards rushing and a couple of touchdowns, and Norv Turner debuts with a loss in Washington. At the Silver Dome in Pontiac, the Detroit Lions in overtime, 31-28 over the Falcons. Jason Hansen, a 37-yard field goal to win it for Detroit. At Riverfront Stadium in Cincinnati, the Bengals lose to the Browns by a score of 28-20. Eric Metcalf, a 92-yard punt return for a touchdown, broke his own Browns record. And Vinny Testaverde, 8 of 11 for 89 yards. And at Soldier Field in Chicago, the Bears beat the Tampa Bay Bucks by a 21-9 count. Mike, everybody is talking about the Vikings and the Packers and the Lions in the NFC Central. Should we be talking about Dave Wannstedt's Bears?
If the Bears can play offense and they can play consistent offense like they did today, I think they got the defense that can get them into the playoffs. Maybe if they don't win the division, get in as a wild card. I think you're going to get a wild card team, at least one for sure, out of the Central Division.
All right, Mike, Joe, that'll do it for our halftime report here. We'll take a timeout here, and then second half action coming your way after these words from your local station.
Join Bradshaw, Long, Johnson, and Brown for the most innovative hour of football ever. Fox NFL Sunday coverage begins 12 noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific.
We're a part of the future. We're the heart of the soul.
Natural-born killers. Newsweek calls it flabbergasting, funny, brilliantly nightmarish.
What do you have to say to your fans?
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Natural-born killers. Rated R. Now playing at a theater near you.
You a cowboy?
Sorta.
You ride?
Some.
I'll give you two pieces of advice, cowboy. Change your oil more often.
And?
Watch out for them blind side blitzes.
Get real.
Logo Athletic, authentic team apparel.
Meet the wildest team in the major leagues. Where the owner has a way with the manager.
He's smart to wear a tight uniform. Really shows off the whole package.
Where the manager has a way with the players.
You don't like me?
I don't even want to think of you as a human being.
Where the players have a way with the fans.
Am I the manager? He's my father.
And the PR director has a way with words. Hardball, series premiere tonight after The Simpsons.
This is the Dockers Halftime. Don't just get dressed, get Dockers.
And welcome to the Dockers Halftime. James Brown along with Jimmy Johnson and Terry Bradshaw bringing you up to date on what's taking place around the National Football League. Let's start with the Dallas and Pittsburgh game. Dallas leading it 16-3. And I tell you, a low scoring affair thus far in terms of what we were expecting, but give Pittsburgh a lot of credit for keeping Dallas somewhat in check at the start of the Barry Switzer era. And boy, he got a good look at his defense.
Little gadget play, but Charles Hale having a great first half. Barry Foster should have never thrown this back to the quarterback there for the Steelers. Now Mike Lerner's back because he wants the football.
And Emmitt Smith, of course, you can't stop this guy. Over 100 yards in the first half. This a 45-yard run, and that set up the touchdown scored by Dallas, and of course, play action work.
Yeah, well, if you can run with Emmitt Smith, then automatically it sets up a play action at the goal line. Good job by Johnson lunging out. Troy laid it right out there for the TD.
And Dallas leading that one 16-3. And again, I was talking about maybe a little lower scoring, but give Pittsburgh a lot of credit. They threw a lot of different looks, but you've got to be patient against Dallas.
I tell you, JB, Pittsburgh's really doing a good job against the Dallas offense. And it's really kind of funny because I can see the Ernie Zampezi, the offensive coordinator of the Dallas Cowboys, replace Norv Turner, who used to be the offensive coordinator. They're very, very similar to what they used to, you know, what they're doing with their offense. Because with Norv and I used to laugh about it here the last few years. Whenever we were having problems, if we were struggling throwing the ball, if we're struggling moving the ball, or if the defense was giving us a whole lot of different looks, like Pittsburgh's doing today, we'd say, give it to Emmitt. And he gets
a smart
play. He got the big play.
And easy out. And make no mistake, 16 points. Not a low-scoring affair, but my goodness, very balanced team. Well, you mentioned having some problems. Philadelphia had all kinds of problems with New York. As a matter of fact, Philadelphia lost that game 28-23. And New York Giants' Dave Brown did a very nice job there. You see the Arizona Cardinals score, that is. The L.A. Rams leading that one 7-6. That one in the second quarter, only 34 seconds left in the action there in the first half. Okay, moving along, Detroit and Atlanta. Boy, that was a barn burner up there at the Silverdome. The Lions come away in overtime and win it 31-28. Terry, Jeff George looked awfully good.
This is that same route we talked about on the pregame show. Andre all rising on the outside, never slowed down. Strong arm by George, steps up and fires it in there.
And then George again finding the guy, Terrence Mathis.
Yeah, right over the middle. Another quick post, and George throwing off his back foot. Feet showing how strong his arm is.
It had to go to overtime. Jason Hansen with a 37-yard boot, and that did it. June Jones did a nice job in that one. I mean, you hated to see a loser because it was such a tight affair both ways.
Well, I tell you what, Detroit did a good job at home. They put it in overtime. They won it with Hansen kicking the ball.
Ran the ball, threw the ball well. Good job by the Detroit Lions. Okay, a couple of other scores to pass along to you. Drew Bledsoe threw a touchdown as New England is leading Miami by the score of 14-7. Dan Marino, one touchdown in that one. And the New York Jets leading the Buffalo Bills 14-3. Johnny Johnson with a touchdown run. More highlights after this.
Sunday nights after football, Fox introduces the most exciting player of all.
Who are you?
Carlton Dial.
He's got all the right moves. He's got great hands.
I hate it when that happens.
And in a clutch situation, he always comes up big.
It's not the size of a man's gun that's important. How he uses it.
Fortune Hunter, series premiere tonight, part of Fox's Super Sunday.
I know you've seen NFL quarterbacks in tough situations before, but this season, you'll see and hear personal stories from quarterbacks like Dan Marino, Boomer Esiason, Steve Berline, and John Elway. True life stories that touch them and their families. To introduce the NFL United Way Great Moments series for the 75th anniversary year, there is the President and CEO of the United Way of America, Elaine Chao.
For more than 20 years, we've brought you these precious moments. United Way wants to thank the NFL teams, owners, players, and staff for making possible the greatest public service series in television. Commissioner Paul Tagliabue.
In this 75th anniversary season of the National Football League, we have a great many accomplishments that our teams, owners, and players are proud of. We're proud to be part of that United Way tradition, reaching those who need help, touching us all.
This series will touch you, too. Don't miss it.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
You're screaming and hollering at me again. I like the smack part of it. And welcome back to the Dockers Halftime. James Brown along with Terry Bradshaw. And let's get you caught up on some scores. Sterling Sharp had threatened to boycott the Packers game today against the Vikings. Packers were victorious thanks to Sterling Sharp and $1 million that he got. But three interceptions thrown by Warren Moon today.
That didn't help the cause any, but Brett Favre hooks up for Sterling Sharp. Little corner out. Corner stays up. Safety doesn't get over in time. There's the touchdown pass to Sharp. Now here comes the blitz up inside. Ed Daniel forced a fumble out of Brett Favre's. James Harris picks it up. 16-10, though, Green Bay over Minnesota.
Chicago's Eric Kramer was at the helm today, not Steve Walsh, and Chicago won, Terry, 21-9.
Hey, play action. Chris Gedney, who are you? Out of Syracuse, that's where. Second year guy, there's one TD. You get third and short, what do? Fake the run, everybody up tight. Chris Gedney wide open. Jeff Graham comes over from the other side, helps out. Touchdown pass, there it is, 21-9, Chicago.
Guess who's doing well in Cleveland? Vinny Testaverde. Take a look at this. He's on the move.
Look at this. Four-yard pass. Looks good, though. It's a touchdown.
That's Leroy Horde, who made the score at 9-0 Cleveland. First two-point conversion of the season. Tom Tuba fakes the point after. He takes it in for the score. 11-0 Browns. Hey,
certainly this guy can stake a claim as one of the best punt return men around, Eric Metcalf.
Nice job, Eric. Straight up the middle, brings the coverage team into the middle of the field. Then you break it to the outside, pick up your wall, and then when you run 104.9, you automatically give way to the fact this guy will score 28-20.
Well, that's fast. And hey, guess what? Marshall Faulk is fast. Third best start in NFL history by a rookie. Rookie, that is. First of three touchdowns. Yeah, I'll get it right. He's really fast, too. Jack Hardy, a little concerned, and he should be. This is the second touchdown by Faulk over the top.
Are you through, Jack?
No, not yet, because Marshall Faulk isn't through either. Take a look at this run.
What a great run. Reminds me a lot of Barry Sanders. And if you're going to have a head coach and you want to save his job, you get a great running back, and Marshall Broder's got to be thrilled having him.
Jim Everett trying to save his job as a player, but he goes against Joe Montana.
Joe Montana steps up fine, finds Davis over the middle, a quick post. Excellent route, excellent throw. Now we have Everett. He's looking over the wall. He finds Wesley Wallace. Now we got us a game. Now you don't want to turn it over in a big game, but oh my God, there's Neil Smith. Mama's in town. She's watching him. She has the Band-Aid on her nose just like her son. 30-17. There she is. Tisha's her name. That's right.
And North Turner, maybe he needed a Band-Aid because this team looked bad today.
Oh, it looks good here. Pump face, safety bites on it. Desmond Howard hadn't done diddly in 3 years, finally catches the TD. But one of the problems North Turner has with young Freeze, the quarterback for the Redskins, he will throw the interception. He will get the inconsistent. And there's my man Wooten with the interception down the field, 28-7. Seattle.
The Band-Aid on the nose.
Well, that's not. He doesn't have anything wrong with his nose, but it's the thing. It's red on one side and it's gold on the other. And they sell these things, and the kids buy them like crazy. And Neil Smith, who makes $10 million a year, is making a killing on it.
We got to sell something as well. Dockers Halftime will continue after this.
Meet America's number one football fan, Al Bundy.
There's nothing like football on Fox. For example, Terry Bradshaw and Howie Long. They're the best.
What makes these Neanderthals so special?
Can't put my finger on it, but there's just something about these guys that I trust.
Catch the season premiere of Married with Children, tonight at 9, 8 Central.
Wednesday, a tornado will hit Beverly Hills, and her name is Valerie.
She's the girl that's going to be staying in Brenda's room.
And Brandon and Kelly had a hot summer, but now Dylan's back in town.
Whatever problem you got with her and me, get over it.
Howie Long guest stars on the season premiere of 90210, Wednesday at 8, 7 Central.
Hill Street hooked you. NYPD Blue shocked you. Now comes a riveting new police drama that breaks all the rules. From the producer of Law and Order.
It's gotta be us on the street.
Comes a cutting-edge cop drama for the next generation.
We gonna be watching.
New York Undercover. Series premiere Thursday.
First anniversary, paper. Second, China. Third, crystal. This year, we're celebrating our fifth anniversary. But you don't have to give us anything. The zero down 36-month lease for the Lexus LS. It's the perfect gift, available only to participating New Jersey, Delaware, and Pennsylvania area Lexus dealer.
When I get a new 24, I think about how to use it. I think two, I think three. I think that dude in the third row needs to chill. I think assist. I think about this man checking me and how he's helping my highlights film. I think left. I think right. I think take it strong to the middle. Can you think of a way to stop me? You got 24 seconds.
Car and Driver magazine says that the 1995 Eagle Talon TSI all-wheel drive offers the most performance and technology for the dollar. So we wondered, what does Renegade Biker think? We're here with the editor,
Porkchop,
here at the Chrysler Test Track to give it a spin. So your thoughts?
The scrub ratio is very impressive. All in all, the styling and finesse transcends the normal expectations of a sports car enthusiast.
Quite an endorsement, Porkchop.
Test drive a Talon at your Jeep and Eagle dealer, or call us.
50-yard line, Super Bowl tickets. Hero, my spot, first in line. Who are you?
First in line, number one fan, the guy in the front row, Mr. 50-yard line, thank you.
I'll give you $500.
No, there's no cuts.
Well, keys to my car?
No, I'm not moving.
I got a football cooler.
I got the same one.
I got a helmet TV.
Minus cable.
How'd you get cable? I got a beautiful Jimmy Johnson thermos.
Mine's got the lifelike hair, look at that.
I got the whole collection right here.
You know what, I'd love to help you out, there's only one thing, though.
What?
I was here first.
First in line.
It's funny, huh? I'm hungry. I'm going to go grab an extra value meal at McDonald's. You want something?
I'm starved. I'll tell you what, I'd do just about anything for a quarter pounder with cheese.
Anything?
Yeah.
For cheese?
Yes.
How's that quarter pounder, fella?
Great.
Mr. Number 2 fan, Mr. 60 online.
Hey, you know something?
Mm-hmm.
An Egg McMuffin's going to sound really good in the morning.
Isn't this great? Me, you, Jimmy Johnson, we got James Brown. I mean, doing 60 minutes of football entertainment.
But this time we got a game plan. Not like those immaculate reception, Hail Mary things you were throwing in Pittsburgh.
What do you say? You saying I do things spontaneously?
I'm saying you don't think like a lineman.
So what are you going to do, like, if I shake things up? You know, do the unexpected.
But you can give a star a noogie.
Fox NFL Sunday, 12 noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. On Fox NFL Sunday, Montana faces his former 49er team for the first time. San Francisco versus Kansas City. Fox NFL Sunday, 12 noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific.